we know how to make clean energy cheap. We did it with wind power, we did it with solar power, we did it with the batteries in our electric vehicles. And now we have a decade to do the same thing for bioenergy, for hydrogen, for carbon capture, and for other advanced technologies we need to complete the job. I'm Jesse Jenkins. I'm an assistant professor, and I study macro scale energy systems engineering. Most of my research focuses on the electricity sector and electric power systems, which in some ways are the largest machines that humans have ever created. So I study how, you know, policy changes, technology changes, planning decisions might evolve and change how that system operates, and to ideally deliver a more sustainable, cleaner energy supply, particularly with a focus on electricity. Climate change has been accelerating. We're already closing in on 1 degree of Celsius of global warming average across the country. 1 degree might not sound like a lot, but we're already seeing devastating wildfires and accelerating, you know, coastal flooding and hurricanes. The last year we saw horrendous wildfires across much of the Western United States. Scandinavia was on fire, the Arctic in Russia. I mean, these changes are partly human activity from forestry, but also accelerated by dry, humid temperatures that are unprecedented. We've had something like 7 of the 10 hottest years ever in the last decade. And that's fueling droughts and water stress that is impacting, you know, where we're gonna get our water from for agriculture and for cities. And it's leading to horrible air quality, apocalyptic air quality, on a regular basis. I grew up in Oregon in the American West. My family lives there today, and in California. And, you know, fire season wasn't a thing when I was a kid. It's something that my parents and my friends have to live with on a regular basis. You know, my dad spent 2 weeks huddled inside his house, unable to go outside this year, you know, with HVAC filters taped over the, you know, the bathroom fan, you know, trying to keep the smoke out of his house so that he could breathe. That's climate change. And it's gonna get worse unless we do something now. I'm one of the co-PIs of the Net Zero America study, which was just released in December, which is, with unprecedented granularity, charts 5 different paths to reach net zero greenhouse gas emissions across the entire U.S. economy by 2050. The Net Zero America study finds that we can affordably transition to net zero greenhouse gas emissions, spending the same amount as a share of our GDP as we have in the past, just spending it on the right kinds of decisions. And so that's, on the one hand, very good news. The other thing we find is that it really is a dramatic transformation of how we make and use energy across the entire country. And that has big impacts and also big benefits. We will save on the order of 200,000 to 300,000 lives that would otherwise be lost to air pollution from fossil fuel use over the next 30 years. And that will create 500,000 to 1 million jobs in the energy supply sectors by 2030 alone, and several million by 2050. There are really whole new industries that need to emerge over the next 30 years that are gonna be integral parts of our future energy system. We need a new hydrogen economy that's gonna create hydrogen from a variety of sources. We're gonna use hydrogen both as a direct fuel to displace natural gas and heating and industrial processes, and as an intermediary fuel to carry energy across the country in pipelines and convert it later to jet fuel or diesel fuel that we can substitute for fossil fuels. My vision for a net zero economy is one in which more people are employed in the energy sectors than today, across all parts of the country, building wind and solar facilities, harvesting and growing bioenergy crops, converting those crops into low carbon fuels or hydrogen, capturing and storing and transporting CO2 across the country, making electric vehicles and heat pumps in US manufacturing facilities. All parts of the country are gonna participate in different ways, and it's gonna impact, you know, communities all over the country. And this vision is very possible. We have the tools today to start along this path and to make substantial investments and progress towards net zero. And we have the time that if we use it proactively, we can spend the next decade making the rest of the tools we need cheap and scalable and affordable. And we need to get this challenge under control, or those costs and impacts are just gonna continue to mount over my lifetime and my son's lifetime. It's time to make a difference and work on these problems, because if we don't get a handle on the climate challenge now, if we don't make substantial progress in the next, you know, 5-10 years, then the window of opportunity to really avoid the worst effects of climate change is starting to close. I'm Jesse Jenkins, and I'm a forward thinker.